And our word for today on this Monday of the sixth week of Easter, this Monday, May the 15th, our word for today is advocate. Advocate, our word for today, our reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 16. We set trail for Troas, making a straight run for Samothrace, and on the next day to Neapolis, and from there to Philippi, a leading city in that district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We spent some time in that city. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate along the river, where we thought there would be a place of prayer. We sat and spoke with the women who had gathered there. One of them, a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, a worshiper of God, listened, and the Lord opened her heart to pay attention to what Paul was saying. After she and her household had been baptized, she offered us an invitation. If you consider me a believer in the Lord, come and stay at my home. And she prevailed on us. Psalm 149, the Lord takes delight in his people. Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King. Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them dance and sing praise to him with timbrel and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of all of his faithful. Alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia. The Spirit of truth will testify to me, says the Lord, and you also will testify. Alleluia, alleluia. Our Holy Gospel from John, chapter 15. Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me, and you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have told you this so that you may not fall away. They will expel you from the synagogues. In fact, the hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think he is offering worship to God. They will do this because they have not known either the Father or me. I have told you this so that when their hour comes, you may remember what I told you."
In our word for today, advocate, our Holy Father's thoughts regarding today's gospel reading, these he shared at his Regina Chaley address on May the 21st, 2017. By meditating on these words of Jesus, we perceive with the sense of faith that we are the people of God in communion with the Father and with Jesus through the Holy Spirit. The Church finds the inexhaustible source of her very mission, which is achieved through love, in this mystery of communion. Jesus says in today's gospel, He who has my commandments and keeps them, he it is who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love him and manifest myself to him. So love introduces us to the knowledge of Jesus, thanks to the actions of this advocate that Jesus sent. That is, the Holy Spirit. Love for God and neighbor is the greatest commandment of the gospel. The Lord today calls us to respond generously to the gospel's call to love, placing God at the center of our lives and dedicating ourselves to the service of our brothers and sisters, especially those most in need of support and consolation. Every day we must learn the art of loving. Every day we must patiently follow the school of Christ. Every day we must forgive and look to Jesus and do this with the help of this advocate, of this counselor, whom Jesus has sent to us, who is the Holy Spirit. Every day we must patiently follow the school of Christ. Advocate, our word for today. Every day we must forgive and look to Jesus and do this with the help of this advocate, of this counselor, whom Jesus has sent to us, who is the Holy Spirit. Advocate. Jesus sends us an advocate. What is the role of the advocate? To testify on behalf of Jesus. Wow. The Father sends the Holy Spirit to advocate, to testify on behalf of his Son, Jesus Christ. The Holy Spirit lives within us, and his role, again, is to advocate, is to testify. Jesus himself says this of the advocate. When the advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me, and you also will testify. The Spirit will testify, and you also will testify. So yes, the Holy Spirit is an advocate, but guess what, brothers and sisters? So are we. So are we. And how do we advocate for the Lord Jesus Christ? How do we take this amazing truth that Jesus has shared with us, this gift of faith that the Lord God has given to us, and the advocate who lives within us and stirs all of those truths up within our own spirits, within our own hearts, within our own minds until they're stirred into a fire? How do we then go forward and act as advocates in his name to the world? Pope Francis says, every day we must patiently follow the school of Christ. Every day we must forgive and look to Jesus, and to do this with the help of this advocate or this counselor that Jesus himself has given to us. So how are we faithful and productive advocates for the Lord Jesus Christ? We count on the Holy Spirit. And then we don't count the cost otherwise, because we know that the world is going to reject us. So for an example of that, we go to the Acts of the Apostles today, chapter 16. And we see, we sat and spoke with the women who had gathered there. One of them, a woman named Lydia, a dealer in purple cloth from the city of Thyatira, a worshiper of God, listened, and the Lord opened her heart to pay attention to what Paul was saying. Again, let me say that. We sat and spoke with the women who had gathered there. One of them responded. They said it to all of them. This introduction, this invitation was made to all the women sitting there. We don't know how many it was, but we know it was more than one. But what we know is one of them, Lydia, listened, and the Lord opened her heart to pay attention. As she listened, as she was open to receiving this message, the Lord opened her heart to receive, to perceive, to understand what they were saying to her. Again, they didn't go out to preach the gospel to one person. They went out to preach the gospel to a group. One person listened. One person responded. The Lord throws seeds. We know that. He throws seeds everywhere, and he's not worried about the loss. He's so generous. He puts it all out there so that as many people will respond as possible, be all things to all people so that some can be saved, St. Paul says. So we are always putting ourselves out there. Sometimes it's received. Sometimes it's not received. That is not our care. Our care is to go forward and be advocates in Jesus' name so that some can come into relationship with him. Beyond the sharing of the good news, beyond our service to our brothers and sisters, beyond our love for one another, and our willingness to proclaim the gospel, that is the end of our responsibility, as long as we are faithful to that thing, and to understand that some will receive it and some may not. But we are about doing the Lord's work because we are advocates for the Lord, advocates for the gospel of Jesus Christ, advocates for the salvation of all made in his image and likeness, because he died for us all. And everyone should be given an opportunity to hear that gospel proclaimed and then, with good information, make a decision according to their own free will. And that decision is always respected by us as it is respected by God. But we go forward calling on the advocate who dwells within us to make us good advocates for Jesus himself as we go forward proclaiming the gospel and praying that we will every once in a while, maybe even on a regular occasion, run across a Lydia whose heart is open to receiving that message. Advocate, our word for today.